Chair, for recognizing me and thank you for reconvening this discussion. I'm Alice Arena. I'm the Executive Director of the Four River Residents Against the Compressor Station. And I just wanted to point out a couple of little things. So the first thing is, I have the utmost respect for our fire, police, our emergency people. I know you do a fantastic job. But I need to tell you that training and equipment and all of those things will probably do you precious little good. What tends to happen with these explosions, it's happened recently in Kentucky. It happened about 3 years ago in a place called Salem Township, Pennsylvania, and it was the same pipeline company, the Spectrum. And then the explosion that happened in Armada Township in Michigan this past January, that basically the only thing you can do is cordon off about a quarter mile radius and let it burn. The gas companies will tell you the same thing. They have to shut off the gas on both ends to, you know, keep it from flowing anymore and burn off what is in the pipes. The heat is so intense that you cannot get within a quarter of a mile of this. And it takes out pretty much anything that is close by. So in terms of the bridge, in terms of the pumping station, where it might not do, you know, you might be able to make the argument that it won't do physical damage, what it will do is take out the computer systems for both of those operations. So in the case of the pumping station, where our sewage will be dumped into the bay, 60 million gallons a day. The bridge, it could affect the operations of the bridge going up and down. And in this case, with this, the shipping lanes being so active, especially with CITGO, that CITGO plant supplies diesel fuel, to a good chunk of New England. If that bridge cannot go up and down, those tankers cannot get in and out of the CITGO terminal, and therefore gasoline and diesel will not be able to be delivered. So there's your functional problems with that, forgetting any of what might happen to the people who are within that quarter of a mile. The second thing I want to mention, and I want to make sure that everyone is clear on this, Enbridge has already had, or Algonquin or Spectre, whatever they want to call themselves, within the past two and a half years, there have been multiple instances of corrosion on the pipes that are already there. So the first instance was about 2 years ago. They had a problem. There's a machine called a pig that goes in through the pipes that cleans out the PCBs and junk in there. And about 2 years ago, that pig got stuck. So that meant there was a problem in the pipe. They had to do some digging. Conservation Commission was told, because they had to dig in the wetlands to expose that pipe to find out what the problem was. I sadly do not know what the outcome of that was. The second thing is that they have corrosion there now. They have divers working in the area, and they're digging up the pipelines now. They have to replace, potentially have to replace the pipe, but they also have to replace the electric anodes that help control the corrosion. So you've had these pipes, the I-9 coming from Pennsylvania, the I-10 going up to Canada. Those pipes have been in place for almost 20 years in a corrosive salt water and arsenic environment. And so those pipes are going to be starting to show signs of wear. Spectre's plan, Obama's plan, is to up the pressure in those pipes. They've been running between 450 and 750 PSI for the past 20 years. They plan in their resource reports, they talk about expanding that and going through the full pressure that they're allowed to do at 1440 PSI on pipes that have been sitting in a corrosive environment for 20 years. So the main problem might not exactly be the compressor station, but backup heat and vibration from that compressor station, coupled with the corrosion on the pipes, is going to cause an explosion, and it's likely that explosion will be directly under the bridge. So just a couple things to be thinking about as you're going forward and thinking about adaptations and plans should this compressor station be forced on the citizens.